Akbar sir to come onto the dais to explain about spellbinders.
So don't you have energy? Good morning, students. Yeah, that's good. So I think I should not tell what spellbinder is now. I think everyone knows what spellbinder is, what we generally do. People come here, give speeches, we'll teach leadership skills and all. And you also saw what people were telling, what students came and what they were doing. But let me tell you a small story. Do you love stories?
Yes.
Okay. The story starts like this. There was a kid who always used to come late to the school. Always. So his teacher always used to see him, used to ask him, why you are coming late? Then this kid used to reply saying that, teacher, my house is very far, that is why it's taking time for me to come from my home to here. Then his teacher will tell him that, make sure tomorrow you should come on time. He'll say yes. But again, next day, he'll come late. Then again, his teacher will give warning to him. And said, next day, you have to come on time. But same thing. Then last day of the week, his teacher will come and say, if you come late on Monday, make sure you are not going to come to the school for the next whole quarter year, which means next 3 months. The student said yes. Again, he went to the school late. Then teacher didn't allow him to enter the class. He asked him to stand out. And class happened. And the student don't know what was happening in the class. And once the teacher was going out, student asked, teacher, can I went into the class? The teacher replied, there was an assignment which I gave to the students. If you can do that assignment, that too on time, then you can come to the class. Otherwise, you should not come, you should not enter to the school also. The student was shocked. He don't know what assignment was. He went into the class. The moment he went into the class, all the people, all the students started laughing at him. No one told what that assignment was. So he was seeing here and there. Then he saw some 2 to 3 questions on the board. He noted down that questions on paper. He thought that's the assignment. Then he went back to his home. Then he started trying to find the answers of that question. There was some max questions. He was trying to find the answers. Because his teacher told me, unless or until you complete that assignment, you should not come to the school. So he was trying to find, it takes one day, it took one day, 2 day, 3 day, 4 day, 5 day, but he was not able to find the answer. After 15 days, he got the answers of the 2 questions. So after 15 days, when he went back to the school, he saw the teacher. Teacher asked, where were you till this days? Then the student replied, teacher, you told me that you have to come after completing the assignment. So I was doing that assignment. The teacher replied, you took 15 days for completing that assignment. That was a small work which I gave, and all the students give the answers in one day. No, teacher, for me, my brain is not so sharp. That is why it took 15 days for me to complete. Okay. Can you show me the assignment? That kid showed that assignment to the teacher. And teacher was completely shocked by seeing the answers of that questions. Teacher replied, who told you this was the assignment which I gave to the students? This student told teacher, I have no idea. When I went, students were laughing at me. So that is why there were some 2 questions on the board. I noted down the question. I was trying to find the answer. I was doing different research to find the answer. Then finally, I found the answer. Then teacher took the note, went into the class by taking that student and told and wrote that questions again on the board. Then that teacher asked student, all the students are done. Students, do you know what that questions are? What these questions are? Then few of the students who were sitting over there, the student said, teacher, these 2 questions are the questions which you wrote last week by saying that these 2 questions answer even Albert Einstein doesn't have. These 2 questions answer even Albert Einstein does not have. So, what I am trying to tell you over here is, if that student who found the answer does not have any idea, and if you don't know that, you know, Albert Einstein don't know the answer, is he going to try that answers? Is he going to try that? You know, Albert Einstein, if Albert Einstein can't find, how can I find that answer? That was something comes in my mind, isn't it? If I tell you that, you know, this is a max problem, even I don't know the answer, go and find it. Or this is the answer, even the first ranker don't know, go and find it. Are you going to find it? Because our first ranker and he don't know the answer, how can I know that? So Albert Einstein don't know the answer, how can I find out? So that is what I want to say. We have a limit on our head. We see that, you know, we can't go beyond it. We don't know to dream beyond that. You say, well, we are limitless, we are limited to this only, we can't go beyond. So if we think in this way, then we can't go beyond. If we say that, you know, that the first ranker of 9th class is getting 400 or 500 or 550 marks out of 600, and I'll get around 400 marks, you know, even first ranker got 550, how can I get more than that? If you think that, you never get good marks. You have to remove that from your head that, you know, he's the first ranker, so what? I am me. I am representing myself over here. I'll do the hard work, I'll do the practice, I'll make sure I will get whatever I want. I don't have that end limit. Here people say sky is the limit, but sky does not have any limit. You don't know how far the sky is. If you see, you'll find sun. But sun does not have any end. You have other things also. Sun is the closest star which we have. There are lots of stars in the world, in this universe. So that's what, students, whenever you do any homework, whenever you try to find out the answers, one thing which you need to remember, curiosity. I want to know this. I'll say why. If I teach Newton's theory or Einstein theory or whatever, why Newton wrote this? Why Einstein wrote this? What is the story? What is the background about it? If you don't know the background, if you don't understand, if you don't feel the subject, what is going to happen is, you'll memorize the answer, and after 1 year, you don't even know what was there in that. And what is the use of that education if you don't understand what was there in that subject? You're spending 13 years of time from starting from nursery to 10th, and if you don't know what was there in these books, then what is the help of that books then? Why are you sitting here? Why are you studying? And why are you doing or wasting your time? So whatever, even if you don't read 10 chapters, but if you read one chapter, make sure you know the background and you should know each and everything of the chapter. And that is the knowledge you can represent to this world. Even Spellbinders, when we started, students were very difficult. You know, I heard teachers saying that, you know, this student, they can't even stand and speak. I heard a lot of things told to us by the students, teachers, especially English teachers, and they can't even speak in the class. How can you expect that they'll come on stage and speak? We told, just give us 40 days, we'll prove. And the same students who can't even speak on the stage in this class, they are coming and speaking better than us on the stage. We are doing some magic? No, we are not doing any magic. We are just changing the process they are thinking. The process of thinking is very important. If you don't change that process, then you are gone. So students, the one thing from this speech which I want to tell you, change the process of thinking. Don't limit yourself by anything and saying that, no, I can't go beyond this. This is the limit. Mere bade bhai ko itne marks hai, I can't go better than him. He is the first ranker, and how can I get more than the first ranker? Don't think like this. What should I do if he is the first ranker? He is the first ranker of this Narayana school, but what about the first ranker of this world or whole country or whole state? Why can't you compete with them? Why are you competing first of all? Just do your best. Just do your best without any boundaries. Then miracles will happen. Did you get my points? So are you going to change that way of thinking? Can I expect that from you? If you want to change yourself, if you want to be a leader, if you want to see yourself in a best position, this is the only thing. Curiosity, and second is the way you think, you need to change that. If you do this both, you will be a leader wherever you go. People will respect you automatically. And everything comes just towards you. I think everyone understands what is the importance of it. So without wasting much time, I would like to give this stage to host.